It looks something like you.
Hello, gorgeous. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm talking about my pregnancy must-haves from my first trimester. So if you are knocked up, this is the place to be, because I'm going to show you exactly what it was that I used, that I tested, that's tried and true and got me through my first trimester. So let's get started. All right, so the very first thing I want to talk about is the most common symptom of the first trimester, which is morning sickness. Nausea is awful, in my opinion. I hate vomiting. There's nothing I hate more. So I will do whatever it takes to not puke. So these are the things that I used that helped me to not throw up my first trimester. Don't know that they will necessarily work for you, but they did for me. So one of the things that I did was I wore C-bands. And C-bands are those handy dandy little bands that you wear like when you're on your cruise or something like that to prevent seasickness. I wore them all day, every day on both wrists, because there is a pressure point there that's supposed to help with your nausea. Another thing I did was I would snack frequently, because there is this weird thing in the first trimester called hunger nausea, where you can't really decide if you're hungry or if you're nauseous. And I felt that a lot, like a lot. I couldn't tell if I was starving or if I wanted to throw up. Like, it was the weirdest thing. So I tried to snack often on very dry things like saltines and Cheerios. Those are the two things that I kept on my nightstand. You can ask Matt. Like, I always had a packet of saltines, and then between the bed and the nightstand, I had a thing of just regular Cheerios. Another thing that I would do often is ginger beer. My girlfriend Suzanne actually recommended that to me, and that's something we pretty much always have in the house because Matt loves ginger beer. Not so much for me. I don't really care for it, but I tried it out and I would sip it when I was super nauseous, and it would really help to settle my stomach and make me burp. And it kind of just like gets rid of that extra air that's in your belly. So ginger is a natural herb supplement, whatever you want to say, that just helps to really calm your stomach. So ginger teas, ginger drinks, ginger candies, they really seem to help with nausea. And I think the combination of the ginger and the carbonation in ginger beer is really what helps to settle your stomach. And then last but not least, once my nausea, my morning sickness, or what I like to call my all day sickness, got to the point of not really being manageable, and I just couldn't even really feel like leaving the house, I was pretty much down for the count. The doctor finally prescribed a prescription, and that is what helped me get over that hump and get to the second trimester. I was on it probably 2.5, maybe 3 weeks every day solid. And then once I hit second trimester, my nausea was pretty much gone. It just like vanished. The doctor put me on Diclegis, but there are other medications out there that you can take for nausea as well. So another wonderful side effect of pregnancy is headaches. At least that's what I had. It really seemed to surface the headaches between like that first and second trimester period. So they started in the first trimester and then bled over to the second trimester. I did not want to take medication for it. I would literally let it get so bad that it would start to borderline on migraine, and finally I would have to give in and take Tylenol. If I took a regular Tylenol, it would do nothing for me. If I took two regular Tylenols, it would barely do anything for me. So I switched to Tylenol rapid release. I talked to my doctor about that. She approved that, and honestly, that is the only thing that ended up knocking out the headaches. I only took it a couple of times when it got totally unbearable, because we tried to do the natural route, and I tried to drink as much water as possible. I mean, I can't even tell you how much I was drinking, probably at least 2 liters a day of water. And then I would also try to beg my husband for massages whenever possible. And honestly, he was fantastic. He would rub my neck and my shoulders, and that would help the tension in the moment to kind of dissipate, but then it would just come right back on. There, it's just, you're going through a hormonal surge during that time, and I think that it's just, there's not much you can do but either A, take Tylenol, or B, suffer through it. And so some days I would suffer through it, other days I would just take Tylenol. So if you're going through these nasty periods of headaches, I'm sorry, take as much, get as much water as you can and sleep as much as you can, because I feel like those are the only two things naturally that really help. Oh wait, another thing that really helps with headaches is a little bit of caffeine. I'm already imagining the comments that I'm gonna get about the caffeine. So listen, you can have a certain amount of caffeine every day when you're pregnant. I have a cup of coffee every morning. I rarely even finish that cup of coffee. It's somewhere between half and a full that I drink. And then when I would get the headaches, I would drink a little bit of Coke. And that really, if I was really kind of like edging onto a headache, if I drank a little bit of Coke, it kind of sometimes would get rid of it. So sometimes you just need that little bit of caffeine to just kind of knock out the headache. Okay, let's talk about bedtime, because sleep is super important, especially during your first trimester. You're already feeling bad, and then mix not feeling good with no sleep. I'm just like down for the count. So I need my sleep, and I'm sure you do too if you're in that first trimester cycle, period, whatever you want to call it. So first I want to talk about bedtime rituals. So I am in the camp of why get stretch marks if you can prevent them. So I have been using bio oil. I apply it around my belly at night. I put it anywhere that you can kind of suspect that you might get stretch marks. So that's right, you know, your breasts, your belly, your thighs, your butt, anywhere like that. I really like the smell of it. It absorbs nicely. It doesn't get all over my bed, and I think it works. So this is a must for me. I've used a couple of other belly balms that I really like. I have Honest Co, Herbivera, but this is the one I typically reach for every night. Okay, next up, I talk about this all the time if you follow me on my blog. This is Natural Calm. This is a magnesium supplement. I take it at bedtime. I just mix it in with some water and take it like a shot. It dissolves naturally. Not the best tasting stuff in the world, but this is really great for helping you get a good night's sleep. It's also really good at helping to prevent constipation, leg cramps, muscle aches, so much headaches. This is a really good supplement to help prevent headaches. It comes in different flavors if you do want different flavors. This is the original, which is unflavored. I think we have cherry now. You can also get it where it's mixed with melatonin for a good night's sleep. Check into that one to see if it's pregnancy safe. I'm not positive, but I don't take that one. I take this one or this one mixed with calcium, and I do it every single night at bedtime. And last but not least, the wall. If you listen to Hello Bump, you already know. It's the Snuggle. This pillow has been my saving grace. I love it so much. It's a C shape. You wrap yourself around it because as you progress in your pregnancy, you can no longer sleep on your belly. You can't sleep on your back, and it's not recommended for you to even sleep on your right side. They say that you're only supposed to sleep on your left side. So if you're not naturally a left side sleeper, you're gonna need a little bit of help. And this guy really helps to keep you in that position without rolling all over. I think it's because you're so cemented into your shape that when you go to roll over at night, it wakes you up and it reminds you, hey, don't roll over, stay on your left side. I bought my Snuggle on Amazon, and then I bought my pillow cover, I believe, on Nordstrom. I'm gonna link all of this down below for you guys to check out. So if you have any questions, you can see the direct link to everything that I'm talking about. Another last but not least bedtime favorite for me is a warm bath. You're not supposed to take hot baths while you're pregnant, but warm baths are okay as long as you're not raising your body temperature. And I discovered how necessary baths were for me when I went through the Great Cyst debacle. If you listen to Hello Bump, you already know. But I had to do sitz baths every night, or several times a day actually, with Aveeno. And I got to really fall in love with the way that Aveeno makes my skin feel, because it's an oatmeal bath. It really soothes my skin. And then also I love Pink Stork magnesium bath salts, because that's another way of getting magnesium into your body and just really calming down and just relaxing before bed. Okay, so next I want to talk about clothing favorites for your first trimester. For me, for the first trimester, I wasn't gaining weight. I was actually losing weight, but I also wanted to make sure that I was comfortable. But I did notice some differences as I was moving into second trimester, and that was my waist was expanding a little bit and my bra size was expanding, and I just needed a little bit of help. So first off, I got a bra extender. This little thing is from Amazon, and this will give you 3 extra sizes on your bra if your band is your issue. If your issue is your cup size, then obviously you're gonna just need a new bra. But if it's the band, which that's what it was for me, it was just cutting into my ribcage so bad. I ordered 3 of these on Amazon for like $6, but you can get them anywhere, Target, Walmart, whatever. Another favorite of mine is undies. And these are my favorite. I got these on Amazon. They're like, the brand is like Gift Pocket or something like that. I'll link them below for you. But they have a crisscross because they will allow your growing belly to have room. I am a big Calvin Klein girl when it comes to my underwear. It's the only underwear that I buy anymore. But that elastic waistband was just killing me. I could not do it. So as I was at the end of my first trimester going into second, I just needed a little bit more comfort at the end, you know, at during a long day or with my jeans or whatever. And these underwear really, really helped me. I want to say that they were like 4 pairs for $20 or something like that. But again, I'll link them below for you guys to check out. The Mayband. So this thing, as you can see, is Velcro. And then this pulls apart like so. And then it hooks into your belt loops on both sides so that you don't have to button your jeans or your pants or your shorts or whatever it is. And just allows you to wear your pants and shorts and jeans longer. It's really cute. Not cute, but it does the job. So this, I would say, is great if you're wearing a loose top or something that's going to be like thick, like a sweater, because you can see it through a tight shirt. So if you don't want to see that and make it look like a big belt buckle, then I would say skip it. But if you're wearing something like blousey or thick, then this is a great option for you. But if you are wearing something tight and you don't want to look like you're wearing a belt buckle, then my pick would be the Bella Band. This is from Ingrid and Isabel. It's just a band that goes right over your jeans, and that way you can wear your jeans open. And then one end of it has like this sticky thing, band. I don't even know what you would call that, but it sticks to you so that it doesn't ride up or down. I've worn this a couple different ways. I've worn it where I put it underneath my jeans and then up and then fold over my jeans. And then I've also worn it where that it's just like kind of like a girdle over my jeans completely. You can do it either way. Both ways work totally fine. And this comes in several different colors. And the last thing that I want to talk about fashion wise is leggings. Oh my gosh. My saving grace during my first trimester, because I just felt gross, you know? And I bought my first pair of pregnancy leggings pretty early on. I bought Ingrid and Isabel black leggings, and they are amazing. I still wear them all the time. And then after that, I got a pair from Beyond Yoga, and those, oh my gosh, they're from Beyond Yoga Beyond the Bump. Love them because they have a panel across the belly that is stretchy. They're so comfortable. I will wear them 100% postpartum. And the last category I want to talk about is food. Not that helps me get over nausea, but that I enjoy eating. During my first trimester, there wasn't a whole lot that I really enjoyed eating, you know, no real cravings. The one thing that I really, really, really wanted, especially towards the end of my first trimester, was cereal at bedtime. I loved a bowl of cereal with just cold milk. And honestly, I'm in my, like, well into my second trimester right now. And I still love it. Like, I just want a bowl of cereal all the time with just cold, cold milk. It's just my thing. All right, so those are my first trimester faves. Those are the items that got me through the first trimester. And quite honestly, the majority of them I'm still using well into my second trimester, which means that they were all good investments. So if you have any questions about any of the products that I talked about today, leave them in the comment section below and I will get back to you and let you know the truth, because that's what I do. Don't forget to visit me on my blog, angelalanter.com. I'm blogging quite frequently about what I'm going through with this pregnancy. And also, please subscribe to Matt and my new podcast, Hello Bump. We're on iTunes and we're on Stitcher. And we're just taking this pregnancy thing week by week, journaling it with a microphone for you guys to listen in. So I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, and I love y'all so much. Au revoir.